Yeah, I can't. I have to, like, no, not even then.
What are you laughing at?
I'm just gonna look at, there you go, man. It's perfect now.
All right, here we are, November 14th, 2015, starting what will most likely be the most epic elk hunt in the history of the world. This is Troy and Matt from Bluetail Survival, driving up O'Neill Basin Road following a horse trailer that is forcing me to drive like a normal human being, because I normally take these roads at what makes my co-pilot, Buddy Morton, and Matt super mad. So this guy's kind of forcing me to go slow. So here we are in area 7-3 or 7-4. I believe we're up in 7-4 at this point. Unit 7-4 in Nevada. We're heading up to our secondary campsite because our first campsite was snowed in. So we're going to meet Buddy up here. I'm not exactly sure. It's by Bear Mountain in Nevada. We're just going to start the hunt there. Got to set up camp. It's about, what is it? So
12:45.
12:45. Nice weather. You can see that. I don't know if it's going to focus in. It's 50s. Not too bad as I hit a bunch of bumps. So it's pretty cool out. We got the Jarbage Wilderness over there on our left. Big mountain range. Does not look as impressive as I look at it on the phone as it does in real life. It's a cool area. We dig it. Matt looking super crazy. Yeah, haven't seen a ton of hunters, although now we're rolling right up on one. Looking forward to this trip. I think it's going to be a little cold. We're supposed to maybe get a little bit of snow. It's hard to kind of get an idea of what it's like here. I think the elevation's about 6,000, where we're going to be 6,200, somewhere in there. So not anything super crazy, but we may get a little bit of weather. We're just canvas tent camping. We're not like these dudes with their home set up there.
Weak-ass boots.
Yeah. We're pretty weak too, though, so I don't want to get too much on those guys, but yeah, got the FJ because I did a horse mod to the 4Runner, so it's out of commission. So I had to take the wife's vehicle. Yeah, so we're looking forward to a good trip. We will keep you updated as you join us on what will be the greatest adventure of your life.
Gotta love Nevada.
Right. So Matt and I were talking. Oh, let me do it like that.
Don't call me by my first name.
About the last video, he said I wasn't being intriguing. Because I was actually leaving out quite a bit about what happened to us on the way up on this trip. We had run into aliens. It was pretty crazy. We were driving along and, you know, Matt, as usual, was just fucking yapping on about some nonsense, about what he did last night and how he didn't get any sleep. And all of a sudden, we just saw a bright light. Matt was complaining of injury to his rectum.
Really?
Yeah, no. I mean, It's normal for him to complain about those types of injuries, but he said this one was a little bit more excessive than normal. So he felt like it was something extraterrestrial. We both don't have memory of it at this point, but there's stuff that's coming back. So we're hoping that we'll have that full recovery of that memory so that Matt can savor that experience, because that's definitely the kind of stuff that he's into. So was that better? Do you feel better about that? Did that have intrigue? Or do you need me to, like, introduce another character or something to the story? Boom, man. Or do you just want to, like, have people watch us?
I'm just going to boycott you for right now, dude.
Oh, really?
I'll commandeer the camera later.
Really? Really? Okay, well, I'm still recording because we gotta get intrigue going. I don't even know what that means. That was like the weirdest thing anyone has ever said to me. That video, that YouTube video that was an introduction to our hunting trip, lacked intrigue.
Bro, so you were like, to our left
right, well,
is sagebrush, and to our right is a barbed wire fence, and in front of me is a truck that's forcing me to drive the speed limit because I scare people, and we're there happy was, to there be was, here. This might possibly be the most epic elk hunt in history. Thanks, YouTube.
Do we know which way we're going? I think we're going this way, right? I feel like we never...
Cottonwood.
No.
Cottonwood.
No.
Yes!
I feel like... Hold on.
Canyon Creek, Wilson Creek.
I'm pretty sure we go this way, dude. I don't remember ever
Bro, we saw the Cottonwood sign like four times, dude.
So we're gonna die. The entry.
You know what? No. We should good. Be coming up on.
We're good.
Twin Meadows, right?
Yeah.
Twin Meadows.
We're good. So.
Woo! There's no snow out here, bro.
What do you mean? There's snow right there.
That is not snow, dude.
Okay, well, I don't know what you're doing.
It's like frost. Snow is, but... My definition of frost is everybody was like, dude, there's 2 feet of snow out there. I brought mucklucks, dude.
Yeah, that was weak. You're weak for that.
Really? You bought a canvas tent?
No, I think
for
that's
$650.
That's a good investment. We'll be doing a review on that Kodiak tent, by the way. I found quite a few reviews online, so I'm not actually as good of a reviewer as those, but I do feel like it was a cool purchase, and everyone's going to be jealous of me once they see that I'll be able to have comfort, privacy, and be somewhat sheltered from Matt's never-ending snoring, which is, by the way, the most annoying thing you can experience. It's ridiculous.
Except when you talk.
Yeah, that's the second most annoying thing.
See,
when
this is
I
what
talk.
I'm talking about, bro. This is intriguing. People are like, these two knuckleheads.
Or they're like, wow, they fight like they're married. Hey, I wonder what all that is over on the right-hand side, because I heard Matt say there wasn't any snow.
That is not snow. All that's right. Like five straight days of frozen doom.
Okay. All right, so this is a lot of time with Matt. We just pretend like, oh, what a great outdoorsman you are with your locating of the dew. Good job.
That is not snow, bro. Everybody's okay. Everybody said there was 2 feet of snow. All right,
we're gonna drive up. You guys be the judge of this. I'll leave this to.
It's not 2 feet deep. It's 2 feet long.
But that's not what you said. And if we were to rewind the tape, you said there's no snow out here. You didn't say there is no 2 feet of snow.
Okay, whatever the f ever. There's no snow out here.
Right. So good job on that.
Yeah, good job on making me spend $30 on muckluck inserts.
Yeah, that sucks for you. Oh yeah, I forgot you owed me that.
51 degrees outside.
So we're good. I'm gonna sign off now. This wasn't an intro. I think this was just a, we'll call this like a catfight update. As you guys know, I definitely won all the arguments that were presented there. So no doubt, I mean, it's kind of how things work. But appreciate it.
Don't you not hit that.
Not hit that what?
Oh my God. Oh bro, it's about
right, like not
to
hit,
go down.
Not hit that what?
I'm
that dark spot
I'm
in the road?
The steering wheel, bro.
Why would you do that?
And then I'm gonna grab the camera and be like, you see what Troy did?
Yeah.
Drug maniac.
Doesn't even make sense.
Shut up.
Alright, so we're done. But that was fun. I appreciate that. That's actually really how we talk the entire time.
Most of the time.
Yeah.
Alright everyone, day two of the hunt. We haven't seen anything elk related whatsoever. But we got these guys. Oh.
Running all crazy.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, there we go. Oh, there goes the bone.
Anyway.
See?
Yeah, you can come on that side for sure.
Right, so deer. They're cool. They've been all we've really seen. Hopefully we'll pull up on this other big herd that has a, I mean, I guess a decent sized buck. So, there you go.
Cool.
So, because we're in the FJ, and we want to avoid pinstriping as much as possible, Matt's gonna attempt to clear some trees using Donald's tomahawk. So it's kind of also a review of the tomahawk and the non-scratched FJ. So we'll see what he does here. That one, the green one. This will be a better test of the tomahawk because it's doing pretty good. Nice. Very good. So, yeah, we're going to kind of go up this hill here, take a look around, glass a little bit. We'll get the review from Matt on the Tomahawk. Of course, the orange gloves are definitely key to the success of the Tomahawk, so that might be, I'll have to ask about that. Well, let me zoom out. Oh, really? You gonna scratch the door right there?
Yeah, because you know how to park.
So, Tomahawk.
The Tomahawk's pretty sweet, man.
We were wondering if it was more the orange gloves or the Tomahawk.
We.
Me and my multiple personalities.
Why you been?
All right, now here's the test, though, right? So you're going to get in. We're going to drive. And then we're going to see if we scratch it all. Here, take that. So I can't be blamed. I think you did a good job, man, cutting through that.
Yeah, it's a nice axe.
It looked like it had enough weight to it to...
Left, nice. left.
Woo. It looked like it had enough weight to it to actually cause some sort of... like to make it somewhat useful.
It was a lot of weight, but it was really easy to like use with just your wrist, you know, like for quick strokes. That's cool. I like it.
Cool. All right. Stop videotaping now.
Here's some more of our morning, guys. Where's that 3x, man?
That forky. That's that 3x right here that lost us.
Oh yeah, this guy is 0-1. We've named him 0-1.
Did not quite get through the fight.
Where's that big boy at? There.
What's no, that that's that forky across.
No, there's right there.
Spike.
So looking out your camera through your window, bro, the weather looks devastating. But it's not at all.
Alright, thought I would just make this video. Woke up, it's probably about 11 o'clock on the second day of the hunt, inside my Kodiak tent. I don't know how well you can hear this because we've got some serious wind going on right now. I wanted to just show, hopefully the Kodiak tent is up to it. So far, it has survived. I actually woke up and double staked it at one point because the wind was coming in. I think it's about, according to my thing here, I don't know if you can see that. Maybe if it'll zoom in on that. Now you can't, but it says it's about, oh, yep, there you go, 30 degrees, which is really not that cold. But yeah, it is windy. And I don't know. I mean, I can't really estimate gusts, but it's got to be as windy as Nevada gets, you know, 20 mile an hour gusts. One cool thing is the floor. That's what really got me worried, was the floor. You know, you can see the air going underneath it, and I was like, holy shit, it's gonna pick this tent up. I mean, I don't know how well you can see the flex of the tent there, but yeah, we got some wind tonight. It's 11 o'clock, so this sucks because obviously we want to go to bed. Last time I went out, it was snowing, which was a lot of fun. See that table shaking? Yeah, good times up here, which is actually really cool. I just hope this tent holds up because holy shit, this is some intense wind. I don't know if I've ever been out with wind like this. Well, at least with a tent this big, and that's probably part of it, is that, you know, the downside to a tent like this is it's like a sail. So we took one of our other camp tents down because, you know, fear that it was going to get collapsed. But yeah, this one seems to be so far so good. I don't want to jinx myself waiting to hear something really bad. Yeah. So, there it is. This might be part of the Kodiak tent review at some point. So far, loving this tent. This thing is pretty epic. It's good. Yeah, this is putting it through its paces. So, good job so far.
We'll see. You see my boots moving there, rocking like there's a freaking earthquake. So far, so good. So we'll see how it ends up.
All right, so I don't know if you can hear me or how much you can even see. But there's a sad truth to what you're looking at right now. This is the inside of my tent. So that pretty much sucks. I'm a little bit lost right now and I have no idea what I'm gonna do. But right now I'm gonna go raid Storman's tent. Man, this sucks!
Yeah, you can't. I have to like... No, not even then.
What are you laughing at?
I'm just gonna look... There you go, man. It's perfect now. Well, I'm shining the headlamp directly on you, so I could totally see you right now. It's
can
perfect.
You dial down the...
No, no, no.
Wattage there?
No, no, it's perfect.
Okay, is it? Because I'm just gonna...
Alright, well, let's talk about our test here, because I know it shows you with the Bud Light, but I'm not drinking at all.
Alright, so we have... This is less of a test, more of a life-saving technique. Temperature took a turn for the worse. We knew it was gonna get cold. We just did the Kestrel, and it's negative 15 right now. So it's 45. Actually, 45 degrees, but it's...
Somewhere it's negative 15.
Somewhere it's negative 15. Well, this is your test. Okay, Troy lit 9 candles, 9.5 candles. One burned out.
Yeah, those three in the middle are not
We're trying good. To... I'll actually attempt to check the temperature right now. It was 43 degrees right when you lit them. It was 45 degrees last time I checked.
They haven't really been going on that long, though, so... Oh, you know what you should do, though, is check your temperature here on the Kestrel and then check it at the top of the tent. This is a Kodiak 10x14 canvas tent. I can still see my breath, so.
So I got 44.6 now.
So we have dropped. Let's check that.
I mean, how quick does this update?
Hey, you hold it up there.
Immediately.
Oh, shit. How hot is it up there? You look epic right now. You look like you're really, really struggling to understand the numbers that are on that thing.
Yeah, I'm just watching it climb and climb and climb. 47.48.
Okay, so this is what we got to do.
48.2. We got to elevate our cots.
No, I got an idea.
We got to sleep on the moon.
Did you turn off the Kestrel?
Oh, no.
What happened? Did you put your gloves in the wax?
No.
Because that would have been great. So what we got to do is we've got to... Okay, check it out.
But my feet are definitely not on your tarp.
It's okay. No, it's okay.
So, it is... Monday. Last night, 3 of the 4 temps that our tents that our camp has collapsed. This morning, 2 of the 4 people in our hunting group are now gone. They just went back into town. My tent is completely full of snow. There's more snow inside my tent than there is, like, outside my tent, which is kind of weird. I came in here, like, what time last night?
2 o'clock
in the morning. So let me tell you the story about my tent. I'm covered up, completely covered up. I don't feel any wind. I could just hear it in my tent shaking. And before I had gone to bed, I had noticed it had started snowing a little bit. And that started clicking in my head. And I kind of was like, oh, I wonder what the condition of my tent is. And I just kind of like slipped one arm out my tent and down on the ground to see if it was wet. And it wasn't wet, which was a good thing. But the bad thing was like it pushed through like 2 inches of snow before I hit the bottom. So I kind of panicked a little bit. I woke up and it was like a winter wonderland inside my tent. So I got dressed. I jetted over here. Actually, I stood in my tent for probably 15 minutes trying to figure out, should I take anything with me? Should I leave it? Is it going to be here tomorrow? I ended up coming back here. Troy knocked some sense into me. I got my sleeping bag, and then we went to bed. And then at 6 o'clock in the morning, Buddy and Kat did the exact same thing that I did, because now their tent is full of snow. They're gone now.
We've restaked the tent that we're in. This is Troy's tent. We've relocated the FJ Cruiser to try to block some wind. We staked down the trailer because that was all cattywampus this morning. We salvaged some good stuff. We've got the Buddy heater. We have the Dynaglow heater. We've got my Primus stove. Troy's got a stove some here. So we're good to go for heat, pending the wind doesn't tear us that way. Then we got some Jägermeister, and I figure it's 10:20 in the morning. It's probably a good time. Here's to you.
So,
not that I wanted to be filmed, because I'm not talking loud enough because of the wind. It's about 21 degrees out. So when you factor the wind, it's pretty freaking cold. That's really all I have to add, other than the Kodiak tent rocks. I don't know if it's going to make it. But so far it's held up. It's looking pretty freaking sad right now. It's got a lot of bowing. But well, hopefully it's going to make it. But it's been watertight so far. It's kept us safe. Everybody was in my tent. Everybody else's tent's collapsed. So thumbs up on that. Kodiak sent me a new tent. That'd be awesome, because this one I think is destroyed. well, at least it's definitely worn. This is the first time it's ever been staked. But it's looking pretty rad.
We should casserole it. We've been doing this thing where, like, every 20 minutes we come up with a bright idea of something to get done outside. So when we do that this time, we'll go kestrel it. It sucks so bad out there because it's cold, but it's not that cold. And it's windy, but it's not really that windy. But it's cold and it's windy in your face. And it sucks, and you can't get anything done out there. If you try to pick anything up, it doesn't matter the surface area, it's going to blow away. I guess it is pretty windy. What do you think it is? 35, 40?
Yeah, maybe 30. I don't know. Last night I think was worse. I think right now it's actually not as bad. Although the tent is just starting to really, I don't know how well you can see that, but the tent's starting to sag. But it's just like under constant wind. That's what it is, I think, today. That's the difference, is that last night I think we were getting gusts that were pretty severe, but today it just seems to be a constant, like 20 mile an hour, probably with gusts of like 30. I don't know. We should do a video outside in the tundra.
We will, because I want to make sure you go show the camp, or what's left of it.
Heads up on that video, there will be no point in talking.
No,
I guarantee you that you will not hear anything. So we'll just walk, and you can point at things. And be like, the cooler! So, it's been pretty bad. According to the forecast that we saw, it looks like it's not going to get clearer for a couple days. And breaking down in any kind of wind like this would be a real task. We may come up with some kind of strategy. I don't know. We got plenty of time on our hands, so we'll see what we do. But let's sign off for now. We'll get out the kestrel out. I need to get some of this stuff that was in my tent just for convenience, but now is in the way because we don't have as much room. Good times, right?
Yeah. It is Tuesday morning now. It is 8:20 on the dot. I lost the bet. We all took wagers at the campfire the other night, the night we were going to get an elk. And I said we were going to bag it Tuesday morning. Here's why we didn't. We had a crazy windstorm. You've already seen a video of that. So, Buddy and Kat left. They're not even here right now. They're on their way back from Wells. They stayed at a hotel. Troy and I waited it out. We just have thousands and thousands of dollars worth of gear here that we didn't want to just kind of abandon. So I'm going to take you through my living quarters. That is what was my tent. So basically what happened to my tent is, this is totally a summer tent. Now let me see if I can get you to... You can see inside. My tent is mesh, basically. So about 3 feet from the ground is actually tent material, and the rest of it is mesh. And I tied the rain fly down as best I could, and the wind was just too much for it. So actually on two sides of my tent, the mesh had lifted up towards the roof, and that's what you saw from the inside of my tent, is basically the snow was just the wind was blowing so hard and the snow was just coming through. That is a sideways table. and there is just mass destruction in there, really. So what we're gonna do here, I mean, it's crazy because if you look like that is the snow that built up in my tent, which is significantly more than building up on the outside. So it was really just getting trapped in there. What we're gonna try to do, I've got all the sensitive items out of there now, so it's not a super big deal. I think the biggest deal that's in there right now is a first aid kit. But I could put one of those together in no time. That little blue thing in there, that's my lantern, which isn't a big deal, I guess. There's a field jacket liner in there I'd like to recover at some point. And I think there's a couple cans of propane in there, which we'll need eventually. Oh, and my baby wipes. Ugh, we need those. So I'm going to hand this back over to Troy, and we're going to do a little walk about the camp. Like I was saying, what we're going to do is I'm going to set that back up. Because it's completely staked down. The stakes never pulled out. But we'll set that back up and then see what we can do about getting that stuff out. We're going to have to put the tent inside out at some point to get the snow out. It's done, though. The poles look like giant S's. It's probably going to be a pain in the ass to put back together. And the mesh all the way around has just got tears in it. So that tent lasted, I don't know, 7 years. Every camping trip I've been on since I've been, well... Anyways, it was a good tent. It's dead. We'll take a walk over now to the the campfire area. Look at that.
Yeah, it's right there. It just blew over the other side.
So this is our wood pile, which in its condition right now is it's in pretty good condition because nothing is wet. It's all frozen and snowy, so continuing a fire is not going to be a big deal except for maybe the big logs. But this was covered with a really big tarp, no match for the wind. So that kind of sucks.
We can stake it next time.
Before we show you the destruction of our kitchen area, we're going to take you in the buddy's tent. So this is an old school canvas tent. It held up really well on the outside, but if you look down here, there is no floor. So get ready to enter this destruction. We'll try to get some light in here. Oh my. Ugh. So this was the Destruction Day Buddy's tent. And we had to come in here and ransack it to get some sensitive items out that Buddy had notified us about, but... How do you live like that? So that's a no-go. That thing's just completely covered in snow. Snow on the bottom. So that's, yep, that was a no-go. That was the second abandoned tent. We'll go show you the third abandoned tent. So this one was kind of iffy. This was Cat's tent. She kind of made a call to abandon this one early. It was actually still standing when we abandoned this one. We pulled the poles out, put a cooler on top. But yeah, we don't know how this one would have fared. She wasn't very confident in it. If you look at this, that's a really old Ozark Trail logo. So I don't know how old this tent is, but we're going to take any chances with it. Now the biggest destruction that makes us look like absolute gutter trash is the camp kitchen. And Troy, you could take it away.
Yeah, I don't even know what to say about this one. So normally Buddy brings this trailer out and, you know, hooks up sort of a canopy above it so we can have a kitchen area, and it's just totally destroyed. There were three guidelines on each pole, and they could not sustain against the wind. So it's done. But there is the salvation in the storm over there, which is the awesomest tent ever, that Kodiak canvas tent. It has held up really well. So that's all we have left basically for shelter. Just Matt and I are out here. We'll see when Buddy and my mom get back to see what their plan is as far as continuing on. But yeah, it was a very humbling experience, definitely coming out here setting up in the way we would for October, never having experienced winds of that nature. And we didn't clock them, but I know surrounding areas that are at lower elevations were reporting, 33 to 40 mile an hour gusts and sustained like 20s.
which was just more than this camp could. And especially when you look at some of the tents that were out here, there was just no way those tents were going to survive. But it's a cool place to wake up to, and always lessons learned. This camping trip is to prepare for the next camping trip, and that's how I got to where I'm at, just trying to think of that worst case scenario. So, cool. All right, well, we're going to get to work trying to make this somewhat livable again. Hopefully we'll be able to do a video that has a little bit less chaos. It makes us look like we actually know what we're doing. Because this was definitely unexpected. Signing. Well, if I get my glove off, signing off.
We took the day to kind of try to restore our camp a little bit.
And really, when we say day, it's been like 2 hours.
Yeah, we've actually killed it today. We're relatively done. There's things that we can do. We have to unmess the trailer there. But I wanted to show you kind of... So this is the tent. We got it set back up. And I just want to kind of show you the inside. So, I mean, that's the snow on the ground. We've turned this tent into the dead mattress storage. So those are two of the mattresses that we lost. I got most of my gear out of it. Then I'll show you here. So this is my tent. See how much of it is mesh? We got a pretty gnarly hole right there. Tear in the mesh right there. Tear in the mesh right there. And then something I just saw on the inside is this stake. Watch your step. This stake right there, that didn't have a whole lot of time left. So that was getting ready to go. Otherwise, the tent held up way better than it probably should have. There's the rain fly. So in terms of the gear that I pulled out of it today, that's not a big priority. That lantern, I'm gonna chalk it up to the cold temperature maybe killing the battery. So that does not work. Both of those are waterproof. That's my laundry bag, and all that was in that is the pants that I wore out here. That sleeping bag is what kind of saved me on the first night. That took the brunt of the snow. Like I said, I'd probably been getting snowed on for 2 hours in my tent without even knowing it, because that was completely covering me. Space blanket down there, and then the table. Everything else we got inside. chair is in drying right now. We'll show you where that's happening at. I'll give this back to Troy. What about these? Huh? Oh, those are my sunglasses. That's gonna go in the gear loss percentage right there. So
we're just gonna leave this up for right now. There's no real need to take it down. Matter of fact, we'll probably throw this
away. Contemplating keeping the rain fly just as like a tarp, because it's fine. Maybe, I think, no. Didn't we cut some stuff off of it? Oh yeah, we thought it was gonna tear my tent away.
All right, you cut it off.
So I cut it off because where it was clamped was covered in snow and it was ice, and we just wanted to get it done. So that's probably 100% law. Moving right along. Go to the trailer.
Yeah, well, the trailer hasn't been dealt with yet.
This has kind of been like a gear sanctuary. Everything that I pulled out of my tent, took a pit stop in here at some point. It's really not that bad. It's kind of just all like...
haphazard, yeah.
But yeah, I mean, nothing in here is getting damaged, so that's that.
My chair. It's good to go.
So this is pretty much what's left of... Oh, actually, no.
Look at that.
That was a big one.
So we covered up all the elk that we poached. We threw them all under here. Now, we haven't even seen an elk, so this is the new wood pile, the new and improved wood pile.
100%
stake down. At least on that corner, although the wind has shifted, of course. You gotta talk loud. Because now we got...
So... This is the camp, this is what's left of it. Basically, all we did was kind of pick everything up and put it on a bin or a table, because none of it's our shit. We have no idea where it's supposed to go. There's buckets and coolers everywhere, and we're just like, you know what, we'll get it up off the ground. We took down the kitchen. Well, the wind took down the kitchen. we just kind of finished the job for them. We left the 550 cord on the ground so we know where to find the stakes. That's really it for this, but this thing's dead. This is done. My buddy's tent. It's kind of turned into our logistics tent. Troy spent like an hour shoveling out all the snow.
Snow.
We fired up a heater. And now this is just kind of drying some stuff out, so that's actually kicking ass. That was covered in snow, that's drying out. My chair, which actually doesn't look that bad, is drying out. My big bag down there, that's how most of my gear got out here. That's gonna go back empty because that's where my tent was. And then we salvaged the beer.
The beer.
I don't know how good any of this beer is, to be honest with you, because if it had a small puncture because it froze,
mm-hmm.
it wouldn't deflate, or the beer wouldn't leak out, so I don't know if any of that beer is good. Lucky we have a whole bottle of brandy.
And the water's frozen, so we're
and the water's
working frozen. Through that. So, all right, man. I think that's it. So, Camp 2.0.
All right, so after a night of absolute chaos
and right
mayhem,
now.
I'm showing the tent, shut up. This is what Troy's tent looks like now. It's holding two people. Buddy and Kat already bailed out. We're just kind of, we're doing task at a time, like we said earlier. Something we did accomplish was disregard the weapons. That is not for aesthetics. That's just the heaviest stuff we have, and we needed something to weigh it down. But basically what we did is that's a propane heater. I've got two sets of boots and a pair of boot in. I'll just show you. Oh, yeah. Just kind of made a little oven out of a space blanket with a propane heater. That's what happens when a couple of grunts have nothing to do and have a bottle of whiskey. We start coming up with cool shit to do. So that's really it. That's just a space blanket. Kind of made a three-wall oven for it. It seems like it's doing pretty good. All the snow that was on that stuff is melted and is now wet. Jesus. But we'll keep you posted on how well that works. Other than that, we're just kind of hanging out right now. We don't have a whole lot to do except trying to prop this thing up. Oh boy, oh boy. Anyways, rock signs.
Oh god, we're gonna die.
Fuck.
Right, I'm gonna keep moving this gas can. Wait, hold on, don't light it yet. Over by our friend who is the rabbit. Alright, this is going right. Yeah. Alright, back to bat. All right, hold on. Coming in. All right.
You ready?
Yeah. If this doesn't work,
I'm gonna be pissed.
Yeah, it's gonna be the most epic fail ever.
Highway to the danger zone.
Yeah, dude, it worked. Nice. Oh, wow. You probably not light fires like this when we're drunk.
Who cares, bro? It's fucking dope.
That was awesome.
I'm actually regretting that now. I think we should have used every piece of kindling.
No.
And made a giant torch.
I told you. It was unfortunately our karma to do this. Do you think that's actually going to stay on fire?
I don't know. I'm not a doctor. Oh wow. The gasoline is melting with the snow and coming right at me.
All right, well, good times, man. That was a good fun hunt there. So much as more so dealing with a camp and not so much hunting, but good times. Go.
Later. Like start over?
Yep.
Like the whole thing?
Start over.
So the trip is definitely over now. We had another storm this morning, kind of. It was actually really funny. Kind of. Buddy and Cat rolled out again, and we're just like, okay, well, I guess that's it. So we were sitting in the tent this morning all depressed. I even cracked a beer at 7 o'clock this morning. And we get a call like 15 minutes later. And it's Troy's mom. She's like, hey, the cows are the cows are feeding and the visibility's great. We're going hunting. Troy's like, nope, you're going hunting by yourself. And literally hang up on his mom. Like 5 minutes after that, they roll up. And sure as shit, I pound a beer and I jump in the truck with Buddy. We didn't see anything. Then we come back. And Buddy's like, well, we were in the wrong country. Yeah, we were. But then he said he was done. He said we're banging our head against the wall. So Buddy was done. In Buddy's head, he was done. And for the third time, I was done. Troy was done. Cat's not done. Cat's coming back out here tomorrow by herself. I don't know where I'm going with this video, man. I had a plan. I don't. Anyway, so we're packing up. We started drinking brandy.